Hey guys, it's Jen. Welcome back to my channel. So today's video is so exciting because I have a fantastic dupe for you guys from the brand Alter Ego, and they really came through for us this time because this dupe has been the most requested one here on my channel since the original palette launched back in, I think it was the spring of this year. That is the Natasha Denona Biba Palette. Now, the reason I think you guys have been requesting a dupe for this so much is, one, because it's just a really easy to wear neutral palette that literally pretty much any skin tone could wear. Also, it's $129, and most people are not willing to spend that much money on powders in a compact. So, enter the Sahara Palette from Alter Ego, and this one is $16. I also have a coupon code to save you 10% off, which is Jen. I'm gonna put that on the screen and down in the description box below, so it drops the price down to about $14.40, which is really amazing. And what I love about this is that it's an exact shade for shade dupe. Over the past few months, there have been a couple of similar palettes to Biba. For example, the e.l.f. New Classics palette, that one has a few similar shades in it. Also, there's one from Rude Cosmetics called the Rude Awakening, which I think I showed in a video a couple months ago, and that one also has some very similar shades, but not until now has there been one that is like an exact shade for shade dupe. They even do duplicated the textures that are in the Biba palette because there's a couple cream to powder shadows. They put those in here as well. So that really surprised me. I was thinking that they were just gonna be regular powder mattes and it was gonna be more of like a color dupe versus formula, but they really just went the extra mile and duplicated the formula as well. Now, is it exactly formulated the same way? No, I probably shouldn't say they duplicated the formula, but more like the textures of the shadows. So they're gonna feel very similar, but they don't exactly perform the same. So I'm gonna get into all of that and show you guys an application. I'm wearing actually one of these palettes on one eye and one on the other. So you guys, as you're watching the video, try to guess which one is which. I can't tell the difference, to be honest with you. But first, let's just go ahead and take a close look at the palette itself and see some swatches. So just opening up this palette, it is so beautiful. I personally love neutral shades so much. So for me, when I open a palette like this, I just think it's completely gorgeous. So now let's go ahead and look at it next to the Biba palette. Obviously, there is a big size difference here. The total weight of the Sahara palette is 15 grams, while the total weight of the Biba palette is 37.5. So each of the shadows in the Biba palette are 2.5 grams. So basically, six of those shadows equals the total weight of the entire Sahara palette. But keep in mind, if you're the type of person who has a lot of makeup, who almost never hits pan on eyeshadows, I think that it's not gonna really be a big deal for you. Personally, I think if you're just an average person using makeup and you're not a makeup artist using this constantly, I think that these larger palettes are kind of a waste. I hope that she continues to do the smaller palettes like she did with the Sunrise that are $65, just because that one's a little bit more of a manageable size, I feel like, at least for me. But also, something that I noticed when looking at these two side by side is that they look a lot different because of the background color of the palettes themselves. The Biba palette has a white background, which really just changes the whole look of it, while the Sahara palette has a darker black background. And I just find that it's really interesting how much packaging can really throw you off, because these shadows are actually exactly the same. But another thing that also throws you off is that the layout of the palette is different. The first two rows are just backwards, so the shades are all in the same order, but they just start on the opposite side as they do in the Biba palette. The last row, however, is kind of mixed up a little bit more, and it's not exactly in the same order, but they kept the general layout of the palette the same. Natasha Denona did a video on the Biba palette when it first launched that I watched, and she was saying that how she laid out the palette is she did the top row in neutrals, and then the middle row is more of those warm tones. You have like the terracotta and kind of burgundy shades, and then the bottom row is all of your cool tones. So they kept that exactly the same as the Biba, it's just that they're in a little bit of a different order. Another thing that's very unique about the Biba palette that they did replicate in the Sahara is that there are cream to powder shadows in here. So you have your regular basic matte pressed powder shades, then you have some shimmer shades. There's actually not a lot of shimmers in this palette, only a few. And then you have these cream to powder ones. And when I first got this palette, I was wondering why a few of the shades looked almost exactly the same. You have these two right here, tone and buff, that look super close to each other. And then you have Rayon here and Pasha, which are also very, very close. But the reason being, and again, Natasha did get into this in that video that she did, is that one of them is a cream to powder and then one is a regular pressed powder. So these cream to powder shades are a little bit more sheer when you put them on the eye. So she did that so that you could kind of get a gradient by using these two together. So you'd lay down the cream shadow and just buff that like up into the crease. And then you can use this one to deepen that a little bit and just create that nice gradient effect. So that's why those are in there like that. And in the Sahara palette, they did the exact same thing as well with the same exact shade. So I think that's awesome because that was one of the more unique things about this Biba palette. So first I want to go ahead and show you some swatches of the Sahara palette so you can see what it looks like against my skin tone just by itself. And as you'll see, there are those couple shades that look very, very similar when swatched, but swatches aren't always a good indicator of how something is going to look once it's on the eyes, because as you're blending those cream to powder shades, they really sheer out considerably. So they look a little darker in a swatch than they actually do appear on the eyes once you go ahead and blend them out. So in a swatch, they do look very similar to their companion shade, and it looks like there's some repeats in here, but once you're working with them, it's definitely not like that. So now let's go ahead and see what both palettes look like swatched together side by side. And as you can see, the shades look almost identical when swatched. There doesn't seem to be a whole lot of difference in pigmentation in the swatches, but we definitely have to see how they apply to the eyes. All right, so now let's go ahead and get into some looks that I created using these palettes. I actually did two of them, the one that I'm wearing today, and I also did a cooler tone look earlier this morning. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you that one first. So first we're gonna start with the Sahara palette side. And I dipped into the shade Slate, which is one of those cream to powders, because I really wanted to see how that performed. And I started by lining underneath my eyes with that and then bringing it up to the outer corner. I've been doing this technique a lot lately just to kind of draw out exactly where I want my eyeshadow to go. I find that it just helps me, especially having hooded eyes, not to go out too far away from my eye and just to keep the product exactly where I want it, because I feel like when you have hooded eyes, placement is everything. So I just went ahead and drew out this outer corner with that Slate shade and a small flat brush. And then I just filled in the whole outer third of my eyelid with that same shade. I felt like it applied pretty nicely. Again, these cream to powder formulas seem to sheer out a little bit as you apply them, but they definitely build really nicely on each other. Then I took the shade Clay, which is that really pale greenish gray. And I used this one as a transition just to blend away the harsh edges of that Slate shade. And this one is just such a beautiful complementary shade to it. They both are grayish with like a little bit of green in them. It's just that the Slate is a little bit deeper. So I think these two colors work beautifully together. And then the last shade I'm going to be using is Jewel, and I'm going to pick this up with my finger and just tap it right on the eyelid, starting in the center and then working towards the inner corner of my eye. And then moving over to the Natasha Denona side, I'm starting out with that same cream to powder shade, but this one is called Tour. It's very, very similar, but I found this one to be a bit more pigmented right away. So I did find that I had to build up the Alter Ego one a little bit to get the full strength of this color. But with this one, it just really applied super pigmented right off the bat, and it also blended easily as well. Next, I took the shade Sculpture, which is that pale greenish gray, and used that to blend out the edges and up into my transition. And this one also blended really nicely. I didn't have any issues with it at all. It was a little bit more pigmented, again, than the Sahara palette, so I just had to work to kind of diffuse it a little bit more. And then for my lid shade, I'm using the shade Monroe, which is pretty much identical to Jewel in the Sahara palette. I feel like the shininess of this one is just a touch more subtle than the Sahara palette. I think that one is just a little bit more metallic on the eyes, but I just built this one up a little bit to get the same intensity. So here's the finished look. I really can't tell the difference at all between the two eyes, and I think, you know, even though I had to build up the shades in the Sahara palette a little bit, I was still able to get my eye to look exactly like the Natasha Denona side. All right, so now let's go ahead and get into the look that I'm wearing today, which is a little bit more warm toned. So first on the Sahara side, I used the shade Camel again to line underneath my eyes and just to work it up towards my crease and use it as a guideline. I applied that also to the outer third of my lid, and then I just went ahead and blended and buffed that until it sheared out a little bit and also worked it up into like where I would put a transition shade above my crease. And then for the Natasha Denona side, I used the shade Freckle, which is pretty much the exact same color. This one, though, was way more intense. Again, right off the bat, I did have to spend a lot of time blending this one out just because it's so pigmented. So in a way, I actually prefer the Sahara palette a little bit more because I felt like it was super easy to blend on the eyes, while this one, I really had to spend some time working to get rid of those harsh edges a little bit more. And this just might be a personal preference thing, but I would rather just keep adding and building a look rather than adding too much right at the start and then having to try to blend it down to get it to look seamless. And then back to the Sahara side, I use the shade Fox just to deepen up the crease a little bit. This is a matte red, but it's a little bit more of a subtle red. It's kind of more toned down. It's really the perfect outer corner color. And again, I felt like this one wasn't overly pigmented, but I liked that I could just build it up to the intensity that I wanted. And then over on the Biba palette side, I used the shade Pasha, which is pretty much the same shade. This one went on super pigmented right away. So as you can see, it just went on way more vibrant, and I did have to just sit there and blend this one out a lot more. And then once I was done blending, I realized that side looked a little bit darker than the other side, so I went back over to the Sahara side and just grabbed that shade Fox again and added a little bit more, and that amped up the intensity just fine, and I was able to make them look pretty much identical. And then for my lid color on the Sahara side, I'm using the shade Mirage. Again, I just patted this on with a finger. It's a really pretty shiny gold foiled kind of shade. It's gorgeous. I felt like the intensity and pigmentation was definitely there, super easy to work with, no complaints at all. And then on the Biba side, I used the shade Shine, which pretty much applied the exact same way. So I do feel like the shimmer shades are really comparable between these two. So here's the finished look, and again, I really have a hard time telling the difference between the two sides. I think they look really, really similar, despite the differences in formula, with the Biba palette being a little bit more pigmented, and then the Sahara palette, me needing to build up the shadows a little bit, I was still able to achieve the exact same look. So now that we know that the shadows look exactly the same, I'm curious to see how long they wear. So I'm gonna go ahead about the rest of my day and do a wear test for you guys. This is a question I always get when I do dupe videos, because you're curious to know if the dupe is as long lasting as the original. And I am super curious to find that out as well. So I will see you guys in a little bit. Hey guys, so it's about 3 p.m. Just wanted to do a quick check-in. And so far, I feel like the eyes, both sides look pretty much still the same. It's been about 4 hours or so. So I will be checking in again in another 4 hours for a total of 8. And then that way we can see how they both wear. But I mean, this is the Alter Ego side. This one is the Natasha Denona side. I have a little bit of glitter fallout on my cheeks from both sides. But so far, I just feel like they look about the same. Hey guys, it's about 6 p.m. and I'm back for my final check-in. So it looks like both sides are wearing really, really evenly. There's slight fading, I think, on both sides. It doesn't look quite as vibrant as it did before, but I think the Alter Ego side is definitely holding its own against the Natasha Denona. I didn't use any primer or anything either, by the way, so this is just on my bare eyelids. Now, I do have dry eyelids, and I don't normally have issues with eyeshadows creasing or sliding off or anything like that. So overall, if you've been wanting the Biba palette, I definitely would recommend the Sahara palette from Alter Ego, because as you can see, the eye looks that I was able to create are exactly the same. The only difference being that I do think the Natasha Denona is a little bit more pigmented, but I feel like if you're not a professional, or at least at like a professional level with your makeup, you may not really necessarily want or need that, just because I know for me, I have trouble blending super pigmented eyeshadows, and I prefer softer, more blendable shadows like this, because you can always build them up a little bit and get the exact same looks that you could with this. So for me, I feel like this is just much more user-friendly anyway, and the shades look exactly the same. They included all the same textures. So personally, I think I like this one even better. Alright guys, so that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, definitely give it a thumbs up. And also, I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. Did you ever buy the Biba palette, or are you wanting to pick this one up instead? I would love to hear your thoughts. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!